If you know your music theory, this lesson will be a breeze. If you don't worry, we'll get through this together. So there are these things called intervals. Intervals are the distance between two notes. The smallest ones, other than a perfect unison, are the minor second, which sounds like this, and the major second, which sounds like this. If you move around using only major and minor seconds, we say that you're using stepwise motion. Any interval larger than a major second can be called a skip, because you are literally skipping over notes. Just like flyover states. No offense to anyone not living in beautiful California. I mean on fire California. Now think about a melody you really like. Chances are it has a great combination of skips and steps. Can you count how many skips versus steps? What's a percentage? What, you haven't thought about the percentage of skips versus steps in a melody? What's wrong with you, weirdo? Well, now is a good time as any to start. Stepwise motion is just the scale, and we all know what that sounds like. Unless, of course, you're dealing with a scale that has skips built in, but we can get to that some other time. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and write a melody that's about 80% stepwise motion and about 20% skips. This is going to be a very quote-unquote safe melody. Not so many skips means that the previous note and or the following note are easier to contextualize. Stepwise motion is small and easy. Skips are big and a little bit more challenging. Let's turn it up to about 60% stepwise and 40% skips. Little bit more adventurous, and to me at least, a bit more interesting. Now let's try 40-60. Starting to get a little weird, but nothing we can't handle. We've certainly heard weirder. Now let's go ahead and try 20-80. Starting to lose a little bit of cohesion, it seems. Let's crank it to 0-100. Okay, that's just kind of blah now. So let's say you wrote a melody and it's blah in some way. Ask yourself, does it have too many steps or skips maybe? Sometimes just changing a note or two can drastically enhance the quality of your melody. Which note do you change? It's up to your ears. After a while, you'll really be able to pick apart what you like or dislike about a melody, so you can make alterations more quickly and precisely. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If this idea helped you out, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. Have fun writing.